against it, you need relief. You're tired of the pressure.
Yeah.
You're tired of the stress and you need some peace. Come on and get your breakthrough.
Breakthrough.
Haven't you been suffering long enough? Make your way down to the altar. Hand it over. Leave it there. It's gonna be alright.
Well, good morning. Good morning, everyone. This is your radio bishop, Bishop Willie Horn, here at Radio KBRG, The Bridge. We thank and praise God for another day, for this is Friday. Praise God. We're moving into the weekend, getting ready to get our praise and worship on. So this morning, AM prayer has stepped into the room. We don't want to start our day out without prayer, without communication with God, without being led by the Holy Spirit. All right. This morning, Jessica Reedy is coming in and she's opening us that we have to put it on the altar. Praise God. Put it on the altar this morning. Everything that you need, put it on the altar. Oh, we thank and praise God for all of you who have joined us. We're waiting just for a few seconds. We've got to really move. But I tell you that God is moving in the prayer room this morning. He's moving through the women of God. Praise God. And they are coming before the altar of God and they're praying. And those prayers are victorious. Praise God. This morning, I'd like to take you to scripture this morning. Praise God. Hallelujah. We're going to go from the English Standard Version. Praise God, which is one of my favorite versions. Praise God. So let's go and read the word this morning. We'll go right into prayer. Praise God. Hallelujah. Philippians chapter 4. We're going to go to Philippians chapter 4. You know how we do it. Amen. Chapter 4, verse 6. Praise. Starting at verse 6, it says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasseth all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 14, it reads, and this is the confidence that we have toward him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Praise God. Also in Mark 11, 24, it says, therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you have received it and it will be yours. Praise God. Psalms 145:18 says, the Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. Praise God. Matthew chapter 6, verse 7 says, and when you pray, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think that they will be heard for their many words. Praise God. Hallelujah. We need to think about that one, don't we? Amen. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 16 says, let us then with confidence draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. We thank and praise God this morning for those of you who have joined us this morning. And as we heard the word of God, let us be cognizant. Let us keep that word flowing in our spirit, whereby we can walk therein and be obedient to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. All right, let's go to prayer. Amen. We're going to go to our sister. Praise God. Hallelujah. Sister Eno is going to open us up in prayer this morning. Praise God. And afterward, praise God, Sister Donna. And closing us out in prayer would be Sister Carlene. God bless you.
Amen. Every praise to our mighty God. Every praise to our wondrous God. Every praise to all the Lord God Almighty. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you for a privilege to pray unto your name. We thank you for the love that you have for us. We thank you for the blood that you shed. We thank you because the blood is still speaking even in this moment. We come, O God, approach your throne in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, because you say, call upon you that you will answer us. And because of that invitation, we have come. You say, come unto me, all ye that are weary and heavy laden. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are not anxious for anything that we know. That, Father, we can cast our cares on you this morning. We thank you that woke us up from our sleep and slumberness. We thank you for helping us to see the beautiful day. We thank you for taking charge of this day, because everything that we need is already lined up for us. We thank you for the dread in our nostrils. We come praising you, for we are the living. The Bible says, let the living praise the Lord. And that is why, my Father, we are praising you, because we, Father, Lord, woke up to see ourselves in the land of the living. Father, we thank you. Many people are struggling with their lives. Some are struggling with, oh God, Father, my Father, to stay up. And some in pain, and Father, do not know what tomorrow holds or what the next minute will bring. But Lord, our certainty and Father, Lord, our surety is in you. And that is why we cannot be anxious, because we have the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, we come to lift up your name and to exalt your name. Father, we come to say thank you for this prayer line. Father, we thank you for this platform that you're going to glorify your name today. Father, we thank you because you're going to reveal yourself afresh to us. It's about, oh God, a fellowship as we have come to fellowship with you. And so, Lord, we lift every of our case upon you today. As you begin to forgive and fix us up, Lord, present us blameless before the throne because of the blood that was shed for us. We appreciate you, Jesus. We are calling upon, oh God, the host of angels. And Father, Lord, oh God, as 24 elders are worshiping you, we are commanding your presence, even in this platform, that Father, your presence that knows no difference, as many that are hearing us from every nook and corner of this wall, my Father, bringing their needs and their requests to you, Lord. Father, we are believing that you have had them, even though they might not tell us that you are God that reads the in-depth part of man's heart. You are God that knows everything, my Father, nothing is hidden before you. And you are God that is God that does impossible things. My Father, we don't know your situation this morning. But Father, because they are hearing us, and Father, they're joining us to say, amen, Lord, we are praying. Then you begin to, oh God, meet them at the point of their need. In the name of Jesus, that you dry the tears from the mother's heart that is crying for their children that have not known you. But Father, that you dry the tears of people in their father, in their devastated bed, that Father, crying to be free from that addiction. Oh, Father, that you touch the alive, oh God, and let them understand the love of Jesus, even as we pray in the name of Jesus. Today, Lord, we pray that, Father, Lord, you will answer us speedily. The Bible says you have not called the house of Israel to seek you in vain, neither will we seek you in vain, because the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8, that Father God of yesterday, he is the same God today, and forever he will be. And so, Lord, in the name of Jesus, you're mighty to save, you're mighty to deliver, you're mighty to make whole, you're mighty to heal. My Father, whatever we need, my Father, he can be done in your name. And therefore we say, Lord, take all glory, take all honor, Lord. And Father, Lord, as we open the prayer line in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, and all the prayers that the sisters will be praying in the name of Jesus, we stand in agreement that you will do it for us, our Father, Lord, so that your name will be glorified. We will not take your glory. We submit under your authority and say, have the way in our midst, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Lord, as we come before you, Lord, this morning, oh God. Lord, we're asking you, oh God, for forgiveness of sin, oh God. Anything that we have said, anything that we have done, anything that, according to your word, that you said, that if we love you, that we would obey you, oh God. Lord, that we would follow your commandments as it is written in your word, oh Lord. Lord, forgive us, oh God, Lord, for maybe not praying as often as we should. Lord, you said that we are to pray without ceasing, oh God. Lord, for not reading your word, oh God, because your word is a lamp upon our feet, oh God, and guides our path in this world of darkness, oh God. Lord, give us the wisdom, oh God, that we need, oh God, to get through this evil day, oh God. For Lord, we know that right now that we may face many trials and tribulation, my God, that you give us wisdom, oh God, and you'll give it to us liberally, oh God, if we just ask you for it, God. Lord, let us have the wisdom, Lord, that we'll be wise as a serpent, but yet with that wisdom, oh God, we will be harmless as doves, oh God. Lord, let us be just as your son, Jesus Christ, was meek, oh God, meek and humble, oh God. Lord, let that meekness and humbleness be upon us, oh God. Lord, that we know that, Lord, we are connected to the one true vine, oh God, that, Lord, that nothing that we do is because of our own power, our own, we can't do anything, oh God, even in our weakness, oh God. Lord, that your grace is truly sufficient that makes us strong. So Lord, it comes through the power of your spirit, oh God. Lord, remind your people of this, oh God, this day, oh God, that nothing, oh God, through you, oh God, is impossible, as my sister has said, oh God. What may be impossible for man is not impossible for you, oh God. Lord, for your children, oh God, that are in need of things, oh God, provisions to be met, oh God, healings to occur in their body, oh God. Lord, whatever it is, oh God, you know all things, Lord. You know the beginning from the end, oh God. You know the very hairs that are upon our head, oh God. Lord, let you open the doors, oh God. Let the doors be open, oh God, that no man can close, oh God, that provide and lead them, oh God, to the opportunities and the provisions and the things that they need, oh God. Lord, as we continue to move forward in faith, oh God, Lord, that our mind will not be limited by what we see, oh God, because we move by faith, oh God, and not by sight, Lord. Lord, help your people to understand that, Lord, you still are the same God, that you don't change, oh God. Lord, let us continue to move faithfully, oh God, and move forward strong through your power, through the power of your spirit, oh God. Lord, we thank you for the Holy Spirit that you have sent down to earth, oh God, that as our King of Kings and our Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, ascended to heaven, oh God. He had promised that he had to leave so that the Comforter could be sent, the Helper, oh God, the Holy Spirit, oh God. Yes, oh God. Lord, we thank you for your Holy Spirit, oh God, that witnesses about you and your word and reminds us and to lead us down the path of righteousness each and every day, oh God. Lord, forgive us, oh God, if we have grieved you. Forgive us, oh God, when we grieve the Holy Spirit, oh Lord, because we need him. He's such so gentle and so. But Lord, we just thank you, Father. We thank you for all the good things that you're doing, oh God, all across this nation, oh God. Lord, we're asking in the name of Jesus, oh God, that you would touch the leaders of every nation, oh God, here in America, girl, God, and all across the globe, oh God. Lord, give them the wisdom that they need, oh God. Let them lead and pass laws and do things in upright and in righteousness, oh God, so that the people can have peace in the nation, oh God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, let your word can continue to go out, oh God, all across the land, oh God. Lord, you said it once the gospel is preached in every corner, in every part of the world, oh God, then the end will come and Jesus will return, oh God. So let your will be done, oh God. We are declaring that even even as you use this platform, oh God, and many others, oh God, that you have established here on the earth, oh God, and Lord, that you have put men and women, oh God, that you have placed that special anointing and that call upon them, oh God, Lord, that they continue to be strengthened, oh God, that they continue to hear your voice, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, let them continue to have ears and hear, Lord, and give them vision, oh God, vision to see what you see, oh God, hallelujah, that they can be like eagles, oh God. You know, the eagle has a sight to see things far off and away, oh God. Give your people that this day, oh God, Lord, so that we can continue to move in the better and power that you give us, oh God. You give all authority to do all things, for greater are you in us, oh God, than he that's in the world, Lord. And we thank you for it, Father. Let your people know that, oh God, that you're not far off, oh God, that you live inside of them, oh God, that you they carry you with them, oh God. The power of God is within them, oh God. They are not gods, but Lord, the God that is, oh God, the God that is the creator of the heavens and earth, oh God, the God where all the heavens are his throne and the earth itself is his footstool, oh God, the God that we praise, the God that we magnify, the God that we just can say yes, Lord, and amen, oh God, that we can stand in agreement with, oh God, that we can love the things that you love and hate the things that you hate, oh God. That's the God that we serve, oh God, and that there is impossible, oh God. So Lord, give your people the peace of mind, oh God, this day that they need, the peace that surpasses all understanding, oh God, even in the midst, oh God, of what they may see, oh God, that they should not fear not, Lord, for you have not given any of us, oh God, the spirit of fear. That is not of you, oh God, that is of the enemy of this, the little g of this world, oh God, Lord, but you have given us power, Lord, love, oh God, and a sound mind, oh God. You've given us self-control, oh God. You've given us your word, oh God. You've given us your Holy Spirit, oh God. Lord, let us continue to wear the whole armor of God this day, oh God. Lord, that we can continue to press forward, oh God, knowing that, oh God, to live is Christ, and Lord, and if we should take our lives, oh God, the die is gain, oh God, that we don't fear death, oh God, that, Lord, we don't care about what man has to is going to do to us, or what they feel or say, oh God, that, Lord, you have called us up out of this world, oh God, and we know this, Lord, and Lord, we will continue to fight valiantly, oh God, that the gospel shall go forth, and Lord, we just thank you, Lord, as you continue to put a hedge of protection around us, oh God, to do forth your will. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen and amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. We magnify your name, Jesus. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, for having a mind to want to serve you and come to you this morning, Lord God. We lift up your holy name, Jesus. We magnify you because you are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. There's nothing too hard for you to do. From everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You are the Almighty God. You are the Everlasting Father. You are the Prince of Peace. You are our Jehovah Jireh. You do provide for us, Lord God, and we thank you, Lord God. We just come humbly before you this morning, just wanted to give your name the praise, Lord God. Oh, let everything that had breath praise the Lord. God, you said you inhabited the praises of your people, and right now we just want to take this moment to praise you, hallelujah. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you, God, Lord God, for allowing us to come together on this platform, Lord Jesus, to pray together from each and every country, Lord God, from state to state, Lord God. Oh, from country to country, Lord God. And we just lift you up, Lord God. We thank you that we live in a nation right now that can come together and that we can pray in freedom and liberality right now to lift up your holy name, Lord God. And there's none like you, Lord God. You do miracles, Lord God. You're still a healer. You're still a deliverer. You're still, Lord God, break down walls, Lord God. You loose shackles, Lord God. You came to set the captives free. And right now, Lord God, we bind in together, Lord, that you would set the captives free to this morning, Lord God, and that you would deliver them, Lord God, that you would go before them, Lord God. Lift up every bowed down head right now, Lord God. Somebody right now feel like they're in the valley of dry bones, Lord God, but these bones can live again. I speak to you that these bones can live again. There is a balm in Gilead, hallelujah. There is God, hallelujah. There is a God that can heal. He can heal your broken heart. He can heal your sickness and disease. He is a deliverer. He is a mighty God. Hallelujah. And there's nothing too hard for him to do. And Father, we stand before you this day, thanking you, Lord God, for all the things that you have done for us and that you're going to do, Lord God. We thanking you for a mind to want to serve you, Lord God, as never before. And we asking, Lord God, that you lift up every bowed down head, Lord God. Father God, that you bless us never before. Father God, the depressed right now, we ask, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that you'll lift up their depression in the name of Jesus. Lord God, the oppression, Lord God. Father God, we ask that you deliver them and set them free. And I again come to you before marriages, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask, Lord God, that you restore marriages, Lord God, that you restore the head of the household, Lord God, the man, Lord God, the woman, Lord God, restore honor, love, compassion, Lord God, and truth in the name of Jesus. Father God, that they would raise the children, Lord God, that they would, you would bring back the children, Lord God. But Father God, the institution of marriage, you ordained from the beginning, Lord God, and we stand in before you right now, and we rebuke and renounce divorce in the body of Christ in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against that spirit that comes to tear up in the name of Jesus. We renounce it right now by your blood, hallelujah. Father God, restore like never before, Lord God. Let us come together and band together, Lord God. And anybody that's under the sound of my voice, hallelujah, that feel like you can't make it anymore, Lord God. The Lord said, trust in him, hallelujah. He said, without faith, it's impossible to please him. Believe God. Believe God for your family. Believe God for your loved ones. Believe God for your husband. Believe God for your wife. Stand in faith and do not doubt, because God can do anything but fail. Hallelujah. There is a balm in Gilead. He can heal your marriage. He can restore in the name of Jesus. And Father God, we ask that you look upon our teens, Lord God. We ask that you look upon the young people, Lord God, that you raise up the Joshua generation, that you raise up some Timothy's, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, deliver them, that you raise up some Daniel in our youth, Lord God, to speak your word as never before. Send a revival in the earth, Lord God. Send a revival, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, send your word like never before. Hallelujah. Oh God, pour out your spirit, Lord God. You said in the last day you will pour out your spirit upon all flesh. Hallelujah. You said our sons and daughters, they shall prophesy, our young men shall see dreams, and our young women shall see visions, Lord God. And we asking, Lord God, that you restore, Lord God, the body of Christ as one body of believers, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Deliver us, Lord God, from ourselves, Lord God. Deliver us, Lord God, from the hand of the evil one, in the name of Jesus. Go up on our jobs, Lord God. Lord God, let us be a light, Lord God, to the supervisors, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Our co-workers, let our light so shine before you, Lord God, that they may see our good works and glorify you, Lord God. Get the glory out of our life right now as never before. We need you, Lord God. Go before us, Lord God. We honor you, Lord God. We sanctify, Lord God. We sanctify ourselves, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, and we ask that you deliver, that you set free, and that you build us up on your most holy faith, Lord God, this day, Lord God. And as we go into our weekend, Lord God, we ask that you cover, Lord God, with your blood, lead and guide every one of us, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, and meet us again, Lord God. Cover this radio station, Lord God, the bishop, Lord God, and all those, Lord God, who have come together that are behind the scenes that makes this possible, Lord God. Lord, we ask that you continue to strengthen them, Lord God. Continue to give them wisdom and knowledge and understanding, Lord God. Oh, we praise your name, Jesus. We ask that you build a hedge around us. We ask that you bless his family as never before, Lord God. We search, Lord God, look for the missionaries, Lord God, that you cover them, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Our pastors, Lord God, our handmaidens, Lord God. Oh, Lord God, the wailing women, Lord God, raise us up, Lord God, as never before to minister, Lord God, to those that are dying in this nation, Lord God. We love you. We praise you, Lord God, and we'll give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
Amen. We thank and praise God for each and every one of you who have brought, who have joined us in this prayer. Praise God. I was looking at a request. Praise God. And I want to say to that sister, praise God, who had been divorced from her husband, I want to say to you, praise God, since he is married, sweetie, he's married. You need to move on. You need to ask the Lord to send you the man for you. Okay? We can't pray a prayer for someone that you once was with and they're with someone else and for them to come back to you. That's not going to work. God said that whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. So, that's a done deal, sweetie. So I want you to know that God has a person for you. He has a man prepared just for you. Okay. All right. May God bless you. May God keep you all. Amen. We're thanking and praise God for each and every one of you. We want to ask you to continue to pray, continue to seek the Lord. Now seek the Lord for things that you know that God is able to do and perform, that he won't break his law to do it. Okay. And so I thank God for all of you that have been sending in your requests. Praise God. Your healing is already there. Praise God. Just believe. Hallelujah. Just believe. Your healing is already there, my brother. Amen. So I thank God for the women of God who have gone before the throne of God. And I'm seeing that God is just moving in your lives today. May God bless you. May God keep you. We're going to see you tomorrow. Praise God, as the Lord wills. And we're going to have a great time in the Lord. Remember, those of you that are worshiping tomorrow, praise God. We're just asking the Lord to cover you, to give you that word, men and women of God. Amen. To feed the flock of God. And those that you that are receiving the word of God, praise God, that are receiving from the word, praise God, walk in it, okay? Walk in it. And we thank God for you. May you have a blessed day. We have to leave. Praise God. As much as I would like to stay with you today, we have to leave. AM Coffee Talk is coming up next. Amen. 7:30. Get ready. Praise God for the Coffee Talk Show. Amen. At 7:30 here at Radio KBRG The Bridge. Thank you, KHHG, for allowing us to ride on your stream this morning. Praise God with our prayer. Amen. May God bless you. Have a blessed day. We'll see you.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.